Good evening. Welcome to Toyotatimes Athletes Now. I'm Morita Kyonosuke, your main anchor. Kozuka, Takahiko, athlete presenter. Day 14 of Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games and our program. There are 234 global team Toyota athletes, GTTAs, from 47 countries and regions, and Toyota Times athletes now cheer them on with full force for 2 weeks. And today, we received many messages from 127 GTTAs in Tokyo 2020. First of all, Li Chi Kai of Chinese Taipei, who won a silver medal for pommel horse. Hello, I'm Li, a gymnast from Chinese Taipei. Thanks everyone who always support and encourage me so that I can win the first artistic gymnastics Olympic silver medal for Chinese Taipei. I feel really happy. I want to send special thanks to my support partners Toyota. With Toyota family support and company, I can focus on training and pursuing my dreams. Finally, I win this medal, realizing my dream after 20 years. I want to thank all the Toyota family members. We've done it together. Congratulations. His dream of 20 years came true. This is the first Olympic medal for gymnast from Chinese Taipei. Congratulations. And also one gold medal for canoe is Jessica Fox of Australia. We also have a message from her.
Hi, Toyota family. It's Jess Fox here. And I just wanted to send you the biggest thank you for your support from all over the world. It's been an incredible couple of weeks as part of the Australian Olympic team, and I'm so proud to be a Toyota athlete, and I'm so, so proud to bring home a little bit of bling. So just wanted to say a massive thank you for your support, for cheering really loudly, and I look forward to sharing this moment with you soon.
What a fantastic, beautiful smile. Having seen her smile, we can't relax our efforts for rooting at all until the very end. Let's keep cheering for Toyota's team members every day. You can cheer for them in front of a TV set, or you can share frustration with them. We can encourage them through SNS messages. Just put hashtag ToyotaTimesLive. And let's enlarge a circle of support together. Thank you for sending so many comments to YouTube and Instagram. We look forward to your comments coming from you today as well. During the games, Toyota Times Athletes Now has live webcast every day at 7 p.m. After the live cast, it's archived on YouTube, and the English version with simultaneous interpretation is uploaded a few hours afterwards. If you miss it, just view it at your leisure. Today's special features look at Tokyo 2020 from a different angle. This one, another side of Tokyo. GTTAs who passionately aimed at being in Tokyo and yet whose dream didn't come true will present SAADI ABBAS, Pakistani karate player, what's in his mind today. We also feature our team members who support the games behind the scenes, so let's get started. First, a recap of the results to date. GTTA and GTTA's countries and regions are shown in red. First of all, athletics, women's 3,000 steeplechase. Cross of Germany finished fifth, congratulations. And also table tennis, men's team semifinal. Harimoto made 2 points, but Japan has lost to Germany in semifinals. And they're going to face Korea tomorrow. Let's support them. And also in the weightlifting, men's 109 kilograms, Litti in snatch 178 and jerk 236 kilograms. He lifted 414 kilograms in total. Also, beach volleyball, men's quarterfinals, the Wickler and Thaw of Germany lost in quarterfinal to ROC. Sports climbing, qualifying for 10th, so not qualified. And Instagram, she says, I'm filled with happiness and pride, and I'm felt a strong love from you. Thank you very much for supporting me and rooting for me. And basketball women's quarterfinals, I'm sure you passionately cheered them in the quarterfinals after the first best four ranking for Japan and one over Belgium, and semifinal match tomorrow. And Takada, the captain, in the interview, he said, "We feel very heightened and very strong passion, but we have full confidence in ourselves. Yay." And then athletics men's 20-kilometer race walk conducted in Sapporo. Yamanishi won the bronze level. Congratulations, Yamanishi-san. And also modern pentathlon, the first day of female, the Kovacs of Hungary for fencing, ranked the 10th, and we held the second day tomorrow. And also marathon swimming, the Hungary Rasovski won the silver medal. Congratulations. He swam 10 kilometers in 1 hour 48 minutes and 59. And canoe sprint, men's kayak single 200 meters, Beaumont of France ranked 9th, and women's kayak single 500 meters, Csepes of Hungary won a silver medal. She ranked 4th in kayak pair. And wrestling women's freestyle 53 kilograms, Paralympic greens lost in the first match. Mukaida of Japan continues to win, and tonight she is going to face Mongolia. And cycling track men's Omnium, Vorikakis of Greece finished 3 races out of 4. Cumulative ranking is 16th. So thus, we have presented to you 3rd athletes and how they're doing.
Now to today's feature story. Another side of Tokyo, the Tokyo that karate master SAADI ABBAS was aiming for. There are 234 GTTAs, and other than those who compete in the Olympic Games in Tokyo, there are Paralympians and winter athletes, but not all qualify for the Olympic Games. Unfortunately, some were not able to make their dreams come true, but they are an important part of our family and team, and one of them is this athlete. From Pakistan, he was aiming to compete in karate, SAADI ABBAS. We wanted to know about one GTTA like him. Mr. Abbas, in 2011, for the first time as an athlete from South Asia, he won in a karate international competition, and he won 3 UAE President Karate Championships in a row, and he won gold at South Asian Championships, and he is captain of the Pakistani karate team. Now, from Toyotatimes, so this is an interview. Let us see his passion
initially,
for investment to
that to participate in international tournament was very difficult. Nobody supported me financially to participate in them, but I tried to manage to take a part in international tournament to improve my ranking, so I can bring Pakistan karate name from Asia level to world level. Pakistan karate future is in my hand, and I will never let my youth give up on me. I will do everything possible to make Pakistan karate alive.
Being a karate lover, he had a special attachment to Tokyo 2020. Now, SAADI ABBAS, he is watching this program. We received a comment saying, "I'm here. Hi. Are you hearing this in Pakistan? What's the time difference? Maybe 3 or 4 hours. Now, Tokyo 2020 is held in Japan, the origin of karate, and karate was included as an official sport for the first time at an Olympic Games. According to the official Tokyo 2020 website, World Karate Federation has 197 member countries and regions, and it is played worldwide. But in Pakistan, it's not a major sport, and Mr. Abbas had financial difficulties before he was able to participate in international karate events. I had the opportunity to interview Mr. Abbas the other day. I asked him why he started karate and why, despite difficulties, he is continuing to take up challenges.
Actually, this journey all started because of my father. So he wanted one of his sons will be active and sharp and martial artist. So I said I wanted to be a legend. Then they say, what do you mean by the legend? I say, I wanted to do something in karate, which never happened before in Pakistan or all over in my region. Karate changed my life in 360 degrees. I can be helpful for the other kids. Karate can change their life because it changed mine. I myself, what I can do it, I will try to take the medal as much as I can. I will try to push harder myself as much as I can.
SAADI ABBAS has been making efforts to raise the status of karate in Pakistan. So the Olympic Games was a huge opportunity for him. At the Paris Olympic Games, karate will not be an official sport. So Tokyo 2020 was the only opportunity for Mr. ABBAS. If he performs well at the Olympics, karate, which brought him to where he is now, would become a major sport in Pakistan, and he thought he would be able to give back to karate. That is what we imagine. However, unfortunately, he did not qualify for Tokyo 2020. Now, what crosses his mind as he watches Tokyo 2020 from Pakistan? I asked him that question.
That's a very, very, very difficult question. For some player, some team, you have all support. You have all organization which do all other work. So your job is just to play and win the medal. But in my case, everything, I have to do it. I have to organize everything. And I have to also win and qualify into Olympic. But unfortunately, it didn't happen. I am a guy who never gives up. So it took me time, 10 to 15 days. And then I tried to make up my mind and I came with a new idea in my mind. Now, okay, Olympic dream is over. Now what I can do is, because if you want it to be legend, so legend always have to leave the legacy for the upcoming people. My karate is into Olympics, which is one of the best. No, it's yes, I am not playing there, but at least I can see them and I can see how does the karate looks like into Olympics, because it was a big dream for everyone that karate should be in Olympics, and it is now into Olympics.
He has already started to move on. A karate, his passion being watched by people worldwide as an Olympic Games sport, is something he is purely looking forward to. So we wanted to share with you the fact that there is an athlete watching with this kind of emotion. Please remember athletes like Mr. ABBAS, and please enjoy karate, which we held starting today for 3 days. Now, Mr. Kozuka, you also have experience of not qualifying for the Olympic Games. Can you tell us about that experience? I did go to Vancouver in 2010, but in 2014, I was not able to qualify for Sochi. It was close, but we were called to a small room, and we were told about the results. And another athlete's name was called, and my name was not called. So I wasn't able to think about anything. I was frustrated, but if you go outside, there are people from the media and they're asking questions. I wasn't even able to understand the questions. And after that, I was watching the Olympic Games at Sochi and watched others' performance, and everybody was doing very well, and I thought I will start to feel better. But after that, I was kind of burnt out and became aggressive to others, including the family, my coach, and I was kind of very aggressive to the people around me. But still, everybody around me was waiting for me to calm down. My parents, the coach, other skaters, and of course the fans. And the people at Toyota, they were all waiting for me. And knowing that people were waiting for me, it helped me come back to myself. So having an environment where people wait for you is a thank you, something you have to be grateful for. On the first day, President Toyota came to this broadcast, and everybody says you have to win, but to people who come back, we should say good job and we should cheer them on. We are telling you about the results of the competition, but there are some DTTAs that were not able to qualify for the Olympic Games. Please think about these athletes as well. Now, lastly, I asked Mr. Abbas his connection with
Toyota. It was always an honor to be part of Team Toyota because they always care us like a family. And I feel very proud, like because in Pakistan, it was not a trend before. Always a big sponsor, a big company.
So he was mentioning this in his comment. He's so glad he's part of Team Toyota. We're very happy to hear that. So he's connected now. And you're always looking forward, regardless of the situation. So we'll continue to cheer for you. We're looking forward to your next challenge.
And one more special feature today, another side of Tokyo, people behind the Olympic Games Tokyo 2020. Toyota is supporting mobility for Tokyo 2020 to ensure safe operation of the Games so that athletes can compete with peace of mind. And one of that is this one. E-Pallet transports athletes in the Olympic Village, and it's there are Toyota team members who are supporting that behind the scenes. And the President Akio Toyoda visited the Gemba to show support, and that's been reported. So let's take a look. But should there be the breakdown of the system, it can be operated manually, right? Yes, yes. It hasn't happened thus far? It hasn't happened thus far. Well, it'll happen one day. It'll happen one day, without doubt. And you should look forward to such a trouble. Yeah, I'm sure. I'm talking about that. I'm serious. I mean, you may be a bit nervous, but I think you should look forward to such a trouble. I mean, we are making every effort to avoid that trouble. I mean, it's okay for troubles to happen because you're making ready for that. But make sure that anything dangerous happens. It hasn't happened, right? That's the only thing you must make sure. Make sure there's no accident whatsoever. President Toyoda visited Gemba on the day of the opening ceremony of the Tokyo 2020. So on that day, he visited Gemba and encouraged those Toyota team members who are fighting or who are supporting the Games. When we watch Olympic Games on TV, we do not think of people supporting the Games behind the scenes, but in the athletes' village, many people are working hard behind the scenes, which allows athletes to apply their full force. And actually, concretely, what sort of work are they doing? I would like to know. Right, what are they doing in the Gemba? So today, we are connected to Umeda Kazuhiro of MARS Business Department, who is managing the operation of e-pallet in the athlete's village. Good evening, Umeda-san. Good evening. Thank you for joining us. Umeda-san, you are in charge of operation management of e-pallets, but concretely, what do you do? Within the athletic athletes village of Olympic Village, we have this e-pallet, automated EV, which operates 24 hours. And with that, we help athletes move from one place to another. We altogether have 16 e-pallets in operation. On average, 1,500 people has been used this per day. That's a huge number. That's per day number. I mean, we started on the 7th of July, and therefore altogether 1,500 per day, altogether 30,000. How many staffs are involved? The people in charge of a vehicle, the supporting athletes got on, the contact, altogether we have close to 200 staff members involved in this. How long did it take for you to prepare for this? When did you start preparing for this? First of all, the project started in 2017, so we had 4 years for preparation. So when we initially started, we didn't have any vehicle system at all, so we started from a very scratch. But this time, the Olympic Games were postponed 1 year, so you had preparation for 4 years. But what did you think during this preparatory period? As you already know, we were aiming at the July last year, but because of the COVID-19, it was postponed. And this year, the situation was quite delicate. People said it won't be held, but thanks to many people's work, we were able to realize what we have prepared for in operating this in the athletes' village. Please take a look at this. GTTA members have posted photos in the SNS, starting from left. Lange Calanza from Argentina. In the center is Weisheiding of Austria, and on the farthest right is Pereira of Triathlon. And many photos with e-pellets are uploaded to SNS. And e-pellets is very often talked about amongst athletes as well. Yeah, that looks like the case. Yeah, I checked those SNS, and many athletes talk about e-pellet, and that really makes me very happy. Initially, within the athlete village, the service is to be offered on the closed area, and therefore I thought ordinary people will not be able to see e-pellet, but through SNS, with athletes posting e-pellet, a large number of people came to know our service, and that really satisfies me and makes me very happy. And athletes riding the e-pellet, if they can feel the joy of e-pellet, that really fulfills the responsibility. Mori Hikaru of a trampoline also introduced e-pellet in her SNS. Yes, I read that. And also the president talked to you when he visited the Gemba. How did you feel about that? Well, President Toyoda said, you should look forward to troubles because troubles are bound to happen, and that really surprised us. But that also made us feel more relaxed. Honestly speaking, Olympics is a very huge stage, and we are a bit nervous. But I think he was paying attention to our nervousness and made that comment. And also, what we do is the work behind the scenes, but the president paying attention to those people behind the scenes, and he said that unless people are working hard behind the scenes, you simply cannot ensure safety and security. And so father's words were very valuable. I mean, we've been reporting about athletes, but the president supports those people behind the scenes as well, and he thinks that including those people, they are the member of Toyota family. So on the day of the opening ceremony, he dared to visit those people working behind the scenes. The e-pellet in the Olympic Games, where does it going to lead in the future? Our service was limited to the Olympic Games in addition to offering comfortable ride, but in addition to that, for 2 months, 24 hours, we are going to demonstrate that e-pellet can offer good service. As of today, we cannot share when it is going to happen, but know-how learned here is going to be deployed in various places to make e-pellet really be used. So maybe one of these days we can actually ride on e-pellet. Yes, I'm sure those people in the society may be able to ride on e-pellet in the streets. Looking at posting on the SNS, I felt very envious for them because athletes were riding on those e-pellets. And it is going to continue for some time. Umeda-san, thank you very much for joining us this evening despite your very, very busy schedule for the Olympic Games and the Olympic Games. It is going to continue, so please take care of yourselves and pay attention to your health. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. only with the support of those people, athlete can really compete in the most famous stage and post a very good performance. And that also helps us give very good cheering. Thank you very much. So we featured on another side of Tokyo, and it focused on GTTA, who couldn't enter Olympic Games, and also people behind the Olympic Tokyo 2020.
Lastly, tomorrow's GTTA Global Team Toyota Athletes sports schedule will be introduced to you. Not much remaining. This evening, athletics, women's pool vault finals, Stephanie Stefanidi, and men's 400 meter final, Mr. Norman. He will be competing in tomorrow's 4x400 meter relay as well. Next, beach volleyball men's, Norway Mo and Sorum semifinals against Latvia. Hockey, men's hockey finals, world ranking number one, Australia, Charlie and Brils from Belgium are competing against Australia now. You can watch TV now, but cheer for them. Now, from here on will be tomorrow's event. Athletics, race walking, Mr. Maruo, world ranking number three. Can you follow suit to Yamanishi today? Table tennis team event, match for bronze against Korea. Karate, Mr. Abbas, today's feature story will be watching intently. Women's 61 kilogram kumite, pool and finals, Ms. Grande from Peru. Modern pentathlon, Kovac, second day. She will be swimming, riding, fencing, running, and shooting. Tomorrow we'll know the results. Next, women's volleyball, Ms. Robinson, the United States. At Rio, they were bronze. Semi-finals, if they win against Serbia, they will have silver or gold. Canoe sprint, a men's Canadian single, 1,000 meter pool, Fuchsa from Czech. Bodoni, who won bronze at kayak pair, and Chepes, who won silver at kayak single, will be competing in women's kayak four. Wrestling, Mukaida, depending on tonight's results, it will be in tomorrow's match for bronze or finals. Basketball, there are six GTTAs. This is the first semifinal against France. They've won against France once, so cheer for them. Next, cycling track event, women's medicine. This is where the teams of two will be riding. And there will be a handover. There are three people. Kelly from UK is a silver medalist from Team Pursuit. And Kopecki from Belgium was fourth in road racing. And Dore from Belgium will also be competing. Football, Japan, Soma will be competing against Mexico for bronze. If they win, this will be their first tomorrow at Toyota Times Athletes Now. And for the schedule and results, please look at Tokyo 22 special site of Toyota Times Sports. There is a lot of information of GTTAs, and you can reach the SNS of athletes, and it will be a good match with the new style of cheering of Toyota Times Athletes Now. Now, to cheer athletes on SNS, please use hashtag Toyota Times Live. Through your cheers, let's become one team. From 7 p.m. again, we've delivered to you the 14th Toyota Times Athletes Now. Today again, we have received a lot of comments. From YouTube, from Toshi, we're connected. Live is very nice because we can be interactive. We're also connected to Pakistan today. There's a time difference, but we're still connected. So we are connected directly to the person we featured today. This is special. From Tomoki, you see the karate uniform in the back. From Instagram, Naho from Naho, Naho, Naho. SAADI ABBAS challenge, don't give up. keep on fighting. By showing that you're not giving up, the youth will know the power of karate. From Yoshisuke. From Yoshisuke. I was attracted to Mr. Kozuka's story. I think each athlete has an experience like this. I have my own experience, and Nagasaki-san has her own experience, and the other athletes have their own, so he wants to listen to a lot of them. So it's because the athletes have made their utmost efforts to the Olympic Games. They have this kind of experience. Now, tomorrow's feature story is this. We're nearing the climax. Let's aim for the goal with Kaizen spirit. Yuma Hattori Men's Marathon. We'll introduce to you an improvement or Kaizen item which surprised everybody. And Seito Yamamoto, the pole vaulter, will be with us live. He's already competed in the Olympic Games. We will look back on his third Olympic Games. Now, cheering on video messages. These are very favorably accepted. They are shown at the end of the program with the cheer song of Naoto Injuraimi. And on my way back home on the train, I feel it's nice to cheer on athletes together. Now, 3 more days to go. Let's cheer on with all our might to the end. This program has been brought to you by Kyonosuke Morita and Takahiko Kozuka. Again, tomorrow at 7 p.m. on Toyota.
Oh yeah, you're a teammate.